Some last-minute issues with the stadium then. But there's nothing wrong with Saracen's new pitch. £600,000 worth of artificial turf. No more mud, mowing, or men with forks. But as the build-up for Saturday's big opening against Exeter continued, the big question was, will this surface leave the men in black, black and blue?
It probably has a bit more cushioning than actually a field that you would have in September, or suddenly the pre-season games in August. It probably has a bit more, definitely has a bit more cushioning than that. In many ways, I think it's better than scrummaging in mud at the minute, where players lose their feet very, very quickly. So normal stud.
It looks like grass, feels like grass, and smells like rubber, which is a considerable improvement on the plastic pitches football clubs like Luton, QPR, and Oldham tried in the 80s. An experiment best remembered for strange bounces and scabby knees. There should be no such complaints at Allianz Park, though. Just a level playing field.
But Saracens haven't just rolled out a pitch-perfect playing surface. They've built themselves a pretty smart stadium, too. When fans come here, they'll be able to use the free Wi-Fi to download a programme to their phones or order food or merchandise to their seats. And these are the kind of matchday experiences that very soon will be coming to a stadium near you.
The sporting world is looking at this place. I mean, firstly, as a stadium, because it's going to be the most technologically advanced, hopefully the most fan-friendly. It's got to be the most fan-friendly. We'll make it that. But then the pitch.
It is no exaggeration to say that Allianz Park is the most modern sports stadium in Britain. It must be. They're still finishing it. And what the sellout crowd of 10,000 will get on Saturday is a glimpse of the future. A future without grass stains, mud baths, or groundsmen. Matt Slater, BBC News in Barnet.